Let's see if I can use this tiny ring to improve my energy day to day. I have no idea if this will work, so let's find out.
So many of us, including me, are tired all the time. But lack of sleep is not the only reason why you feel tired. There are 7 factors that affect your daily energy. This smart ring promises to help you optimize these factors and give you more energy.
Check your body's battery level.
As a sleep scientist, I'm putting it to the test and seeing how it stacks up to the latest research.
This is the new Samsung Galaxy Ring, and when I first heard about a feature that it has called the energy score, I have to admit, I was a bit skeptical. It's interesting to have some information about why you should have energy or why you should be tired, but is it useful? I also need to mention at this point that this video is sponsored by Samsung Health. I've actually been working with Samsung and on this ring since last year. I'm on their wearable wellness council, but that doesn't mean that as an expert, I can't be skeptical and have my own opinions about what this ring and the energy score is like.
I'm using the Galaxy Ring for the first time, and I have to admit I do love this stuff because I'm a gadget girly.
This is my Samsung arm.
Though this energy score can help all of us figure out why we might not have energy and feel tired all the time. Now, these 7 factors that contribute towards your daily energy into 3 categories: sleep regularity, how consistent your sleep is, physical activity, and heart rate. And we'll dive into all of these in more detail.
So I knew what these factors were, but now I've actually been using the ring. I think they're pretty genius for 2 specific reasons. The first one is that they focus on sleep regularity rather than sleep duration or how long you've been asleep. And this is kind of genius because sleep regularity is super important for your overall health, but also for you to feel energized every day, but it's kind of boring. Like, who wants to go to bed and get up at the same time every day? So in this way, it's been gamified and it's interesting because you can actually follow along your score. And second, outside of sleep, there's a focus on physical activity, which is really important for your health, but also consistent energy, but something that a lot of people don't necessarily think of. And for me, I mean, my sleep is great, but my energy score isn't fantastic because of the factors that are not sleep. So my energy score is not great because I don't get consistent physical activity. You could say I'm kind of lazy. So this is day 1 of me going for a daily walk to try to improve my energy score.
So while I am just being a perfectionist, seeing if I can get to 100, I did promise you more info on what these 7 factors are and what the research says.
So sleep time average is the average amount of sleep time that you have gotten over the past 7 days. Mine is 8 hours and 55 minutes a night, which I feel is a bit aggressive. Sleep time consistency is how much your sleep times for the last 7 days vary from your average. So it's kind of looking that you're getting around about the same amount of sleep every night over the past 7 nights. Then you have bed wake time consistency, which is basically when you're going to bed. It measures the midpoint of that. So it's like, okay, when you're in bed, is the middle of your time in bed around about the same time every single night? And then sleep timing is actually looking at your circadian rhythm. So what's the optimal time for you to be asleep every single night? For me, it's between 11 p.m. and 2 a.m. And they're the 4 things that make up sleep regularity. For me, as a sleep scientist, what makes all of this so cool, the reason why I was impressed and had this aha moment, are the links from these components of the energy score to research. So sleep regularity has been very hot right now in sleep research. Last year, this article came out that is actually still the most popular article in the journal Sleep, which maybe no one cares about except for me, but it was basically saying that sleep regularity is a stronger predictor of mortality risk than sleep duration. If you want to live a long life that is free of disease, it is potentially more important that you're getting regular sleep, going to bed and getting up at the same time every day, than focusing on how long you are sleeping for. And then this consensus statement came out. So people who are the top in their field came out to say that yes, sleep regularity is really, really important for health and performance. So all of this stuff has gone into the energy score to be like, yeah, this is all really super duper important. And this is actually what's contributing to us feeling tired or having energy throughout the day. This is day 4. Still doesn't get any easier to walk on sand. So physical activity is just how active you were the previous day, and that factors into your energy score for today. It takes into account the total time that you were walking or moving, how hard that exercise was, and how consistent you are day to day. I think I need to tell you one of the reasons why I've been so tired lately and sleeping for 9 hours every night is because I've been growing a human. How is this for an announcement in the middle of a video? And it's tiring. But to be honest with you, everyone has something going on. Some people work night shift. Some people have like 4 small children. So I do still wanna have more energy throughout the day. Like, I'm not being too hard on myself. It's just something that I want for myself during this time. But you know, that's why I'm sleeping for 9 hours a night. We also have heart rate. They're the last two that make up the components of the energy score. So your sleeping heart rate compares your last night's heart rate to your 7-day average. So again, you're just going for consistency. A lower sleeping heart rate is generally an indication of better overall health, but of course there is some variability from person to person. And the last thing is a topic that is very hot right now in the wellness world, if you follow any podcast bros who like to talk about this, and that's heart rate variability. That is essentially the time in between your heartbeats that you have. And higher heart rate variability is actually good because it means your body is more adaptable. Your heart rate can respond to stress, to exercise, to relaxation in a better way. If you have low heart rate variability, it means that your body isn't adapting as well. So these are the 7 components that make up the energy score, or the formula for you to feel less tired.
My week of walking has finished and my energy score is excellent. I'm very happy about this. So you can see it's beautiful. My physical activity is excellent. So I have that to thank. And I mean, I feel pretty good. I feel energized. We can see that there's been an improvement over the week. And yeah, this supports what's in the research. Physical activity is really good at reducing daytime fatigue, being out in the sunlight. It is all associated with better sleep quality. So I'm doing all the things and it's working.
But overall, using the ring has actually given me more confidence that I'm doing the right things, that even though I do feel tired from time to time, that is normal for me and I have a great energy score. What can I say?
But please remember that I'm a perfectionist, and when it comes to your health, you do you.
The most important thing to take away from this video is not that you need to do all of the things all of the time. It's that if you are feeling tired all the time and you want to have more energy, it's a matter of holistic health and thinking about our health holistically, whether that be our sleep, our physical activity, our heart rate, and even what we're eating.
If you're after more info on sleep health or how you can boost your sleep regularity, for example, please check out my other content. And thank you to Samsung Health for supporting me and the channel.